Hi, everyone. My name is Tennyson Holloway. I'm the fellow at Public Knowledge, which is a public interest consumer rights organization in Washington, D.C. And so a little bit about me before the fellowship. I am an undergrad student at the University of California, San Diego, studying mathematics with a focus in computer science because they didn't let me into computer science because it's too full. And I'm a campus radio station engineer, and I was really inspired by these societal cornerstone projects, Wikipedia, Tor, Creative Commons, and also the stories of other people who have gone through this space, so Aaron Swartz and Edward Snowden. And so this kind of seems like the perfect mix of variables for this fellowship, and so that's kind of what happened when the fellowship came up. I was like, this is perfect. I want to take a break from school and I want to pursue my dreams and being like these other people and contributing to the projects that really shape our society. So I ended up at Public Knowledge. And so Public Knowledge has a really good fellowship program that is already in place. And so they have two-year fellowships, and part of it is attending a lot of things. So attending congressional committee sessions, tech industry conferences, FCC meetings. And so it's a lot of going places and not a lot of saying things. It's kind of just showing up. And so a part of this process is learning through experience, you know, kind of like being in the room while people are voting on a bill or marking up a bill, seeing people vote by proxy or not vote at all, as some Congress people do. And a lot of it is actually showing up and being seen by other people. So as you go to these things in Washington, D.C., you see the same faces over and over and over again. And if you know what they're doing, you see that they care. And so that's something key that I learned that I'll talk about later. And so I didn't just go to stuff. I also worked on some software projects, and I did some technical research for them. And so I'm going to show you some software projects and kind of talk about my lessons that I've learned doing that for Public Knowledge. So this is a interactive visual about the public domain. So public knowledge does a lot of IP law. So I thought it would be perfect to make a little interactive visual explaining the public domain to people and how expanding copyright terms isn't actually a good thing. So it was a really useful project, just not for public knowledge. I mean, it's an organization full of lawyers, and they do a lot of PDFs and stuff, and they're not really used to, you know, a video game about public domain. So my next project was the SMS Congress Tracker. It was an interface into Congress that let you subscribe to updates and basically view a lot of the data that goes on in Congress, specifically about like bill voting and kind of the breakdown of that. And so again, it's a really useful project, just it didn't really fit in with public knowledge. So and this is kind of like a result of coming from like I want to solve the problem mindset coming into Washington, where it's not exactly that mindset. So after a few months of trying these things and not exactly sticking, something came up called CPNI, which is Consumer Proprietary Network Information, which is basically your telecommunications company has these certain data points. Like if you're making a phone call, it's your number, the number you're calling, and the time. But translated into the broadband context, it's actually hundreds of things. It's the IP address, consecutive requests, domain names, ports, headers. And so an organization like Public Knowledge is really set up to deal with these things at the FCC level, but they're not set up to deal with the technical parts. So usually what they do is they contract it out. And that takes a lot of time and takes a lot of emails. But having me there, I was able to kind of get this done on the same day. Say like, okay, here's what an internet service provider can see, and here's where they can possibly abuse that. And so when this came out, which is the notice of proposed rulemaking for the NPRM rules, Public Knowledge was prepared for it. And they're prepared to make comments on it that are technically backed. So kind of in summary, like what did I learn and who am I now? I learned that timelines in Washington are unlike timelines anywhere else. So one organization can definitely not control what goes on in DC. It takes a large coalition over many, many years to even get Congress to consider something or the FCC to consider something. And so that was kind of the trouble of a 10-month fellowship, is kind of just being subject to the ebb and flow of Washington and not being able to really control your own path. I also learned that advocacy is about showing up and being seen. So probably about 20% of advocacy is actually being a really master in your subject, but the other 80% is having people see you and know that you're the master of that subject. And so that's a big part of Washington, is seeing all the faces and shaking the hands of people. So what am I doing after the fellowship? Well, I'm going back to school, hopefully continuing in mathematics, hopefully computer science if they let me in. and I'm going to pursue a career in computer science advocacy, thanks to Mozilla and the Ford Foundation for showing me that it's possible. So that's it.